Hey. I am here and I'm happy to be here, and we have a lot to cover tonight, and we have questions that you've submitted. And if you look behind me, I'm gonna tilt my screen up. We had a webinar last night, okay, on the pros and cons of a street food vending, catering, hot dog carts, whatever, right? Where I covered the nitty-gritty, the good, the bad, the ugly, the beautiful, the whole works, right? Well, I don't know if you've been watching the news, but the Eastern Seaboard got slammed with this denial of service, DOS attacks. And so Amazon went down, Twitter went down, Instagram went down, tons of sites went down, hundreds of sites went down. Well, because everybody has servers that go into a main hub, we were down some of the day. And it made a mess of things. Let me change my message here. There we go. So anyway, we were having a nightmare today. But besides that, despite all that, unbelievable week. Unbelievable week. I'm talking, I got news from 4 or 5 different vendors that I spoke with personally. One might do a live thing with me. He made over 20 grand his first month vending. And that, I don't know what to tell you. If you were watching me the other day, it made me cry. Which sounds crappy, but I'm a wuss. So it made me cry. If you heard a story, I don't know how you can have a heart and not cry. Anyway, it excited me that he did it. Some other vendors have done it. We've posted them up over at learnhotdogs.com. Unbelievable stuff. Wendy. Heather posted up an article from Wendy that she wrote in and got a used cart and did this and that. And you go, it's inspiring, right? And if you've been doing this, you already know. I'm preaching to the choir at that point. But if you're just thinking about it, maybe some things you should take note of. If you see the smoke going across the screen, it's because I'm smoking a cigarette. We have a lot to do tonight, and I'm excited. Heather says, you can tell when I'm excited when my dimples show. I want to show you something. We're sending this out tonight, okay? We're going to send this to somebody tonight. And we gave one of these away last week. We're giving away another one. I accidentally ordered 2. I don't know how that happened. But anyway, I'm giving away one tonight to somebody that's listening live. Now, I can't see the live screen. All I can see is I have Heather pulled up on Skype. And you'll see me every now and then look over here to the Skype. So Heather, I know you can hear me. All I can see is your Skype. I'm not on Facebook. I'm not anywhere. I can't see any of the questions. You'll have to deliver those to me through Skype because that's the only way I can get them right now. But we are giving away this tonight to somebody. I hope you win. Not you, but you. Yeah, you. Right there. I hope you win. And I'll send it to you free. There's no catch, no gimmicks. Just take it and do me a favor and send a picture once you get it. If you hang around for this short live Facebook feed, I'm going to be covering, look right here, pros and cons of the street food vending business and all the different stuff, everything about it. I'm going to be brutally honest. I'm going to tell you about the crap that's involved, okay? So if you want to hang around, I'm going to go right into that after this, directly. You don't have to sign up. You don't have to do anything. Just be here, and you'll get it. So that's what we'll be doing. Every now and then, you'll see me post up something new, like right now. I just changed the bottom scroller thing. Like if you type in Cater Pro right now, to the number 44222. Pretend like you live in the 1920s and phone numbers were shorter. Text 44222. That's the phone number. the entire phone number. Don't email me and go, Ben, what's the area code? I got those, okay? You don't need an area code. Just 44222. That's it. And put in the words Cater Pro. Cater Pro all together, just like it's shown there. You'll be entered to win. I'm giving one of those away, not next month, but the next, December. Somebody's going to win one of those. If you're in VendorsUnited.com's group, VendorsUnited.com, you can, there's another cart going to be given away. We're giving away two carts this year. I'm excited as heck. Dimples, see? I'm excited because you watch what these people do. And you watch what people do when they get a leg up. They get a boost that they didn't expect. I wish that I was a multi-bajillionaire because that's all I would do is just make carts, give carts away, teach people how to run them. That's what I would do for a living. Not a living, but that's what I'd do for fun. That'd be my fun. 40 hours a week, 60 hours a week. That's what I call living. Vendor of the week this week, Rockies. I'm outside. Okay, I am outside, and I turned on a light for Michael Wood because he said, "Oh, it's real dark." The other night, I did a broadcast, and it was real dark. Not dark anymore. Anyway, Rockies hot dog cart is the vendor of the week. And now you're maybe going, "Well, I have a cart, and how do I enter to win?" You don't have to enter to win. We just look you up. We're like sneaky. We're like 007 looking through the interwebs, looking for the person that posts a lot or has a lot of pictures of their hot dogs and stuff, and then we make them vendor of the week. It's the joy of doing this. I love it. So that's what we're doing. I need to check my... Okay. So... I do have another question. I've got several questions I'm going to answer tonight, so don't think I'm going to skip you. I'm not going to skip you. Let's see here. If you see me looking down, I'm looking at my notes that Heather made me. So the steamer I showed you, we're giving that away tonight. You got to be present to win. I hope you're here. Can't tell how many people are here. Hope there's people here. Otherwise, I get it. Oh, if you want to, there's people that have emailed us and said, Ben, I don't get updates. I don't know when you're doing stuff. I don't know about this. And so we created a way for you to get in our list easy and quickly. And I'm not going to bombard you, okay, for the simple fact that it cost me a fortune to send you the messages. Emails are cheap, but as far as sending you a message through text or voicemail is expensive right now. And so I do it sparingly. I only do it when it's really, really important. Okay? So, or I think it is. I'm a little biased. So here's what I want you to write down and do this tonight. And you can do it right now. You can grab your phone and go, I'm going to call a new number, text a new number. And put in the number 292929. Three two nines. 292929. Okay? And punch in the message. You don't put anything hi, Ben, or anything. It won't work. Put in street food as one word. Street food. Okay? You're on my list. You'll be on my list. And now you'll get access immediately when I do something crazy. In 2 weeks, I've sent one of those out. So it's not like I bombard you with blah. Oh, Ben's doing a thing. Or Ben posted a funny picture. It's none of that. It's very simple, very easy to do. And if you ever want to stop, you just text back, stop, and it instantly stops. So, that's the way to do that. That has nothing to do with winning the cart, though. Okay, I already gave you that. If you missed it, you'll want to go back to the beginning of this and catch that. Here's something cool. This is notes. Okay, notes from the Heather. Okay, new vendor. Excited. Okay, that's Heather's note. Benjamin says, I'm very excited about starting my own business. I have been in construction field for quite a while, and it is getting tired of making another man rich while I put in my sweat and time. This will give me the opportunity to take it wherever I decide, which is ultimately helping others find success. I can't wait to begin. That makes me happy. Plus, he's got a cool name. How can you go wrong with Ben? It's just a cool name. Heather just says, hello. We got a comment. Hello, Ben. Just want to let you know that you answered my question on your webinar last week and took your advice, went down to the city hall, asked for a business license, filled out the paperwork, and added catering to the end of my name. Good for you. I don't know who you are, but good for you. That's freaking awesome. I love it that, and a lot of you may be going, well, what question did you answer? I don't know, but we put all this stuff up on the podcast. We put all of this stuff up on the blog. Go to learnhotdogs.com and get it all. I don't hide it. Okay. So thank you, Benjamin, for your, awesome news. It makes me happy. Let me see what else we got here. This is a YouTube commenter. I recently sold hot dogs for charity. I sold a dog chips lemonade for $5 as a combo. No dogs or chips alone because it was charity, etc. In any case, I sold $200 in profits real quick. I kept none of the money, of course, but it made me wonder. I'm pretty outgoing fella and I like to interact with people. So I'm considering selling hot dogs. We didn't have a cart that day. We just used a small... I love this. If y'all don't know about my instant vendor course, this is right up that alley. Okay, and maybe Heather will put the link down below, instant vendor course. We didn't have a cart that day. We just... a small table and a pot on a small gas stove and cooked all the dogs that way. We put out mustard, ketchup, etc. and let people serve themselves. Seemed pretty simple, but my customers were pretty friendly. Church friends, people I knew, etc. I'm thinking it's probably not that easy, however. No, it is. It's actually that easy. Any advice? Thinking of doing this part-time. Can I get away with just having a table and a machine that heats up dogs, etc.? Yes, I just did a webinar. You can go to learnhotdogs.com. I did a webinar on how to start with little to no money. Okay, then I have a course. If you want to take the course, you don't need to. You don't. Heather's going to have the link. But you can go take the course if you want to. And it's going to give you more information, more secret-y stuff. Okay? But you don't have to. You don't have to spend the money. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you that you did that and that you donated the money. And you did a good job. Yes, it's that easy. You think because, oh, they're church friends. No, it doesn't change anything. I'm telling you, a warm market or a cold market, there's no difference. There's thousands of vendors, thousands listening vendors that you can go to our page, talk to thousands of vendors. Okay. You can go over to the page on Facebook, the hot dog page. Facebook.com/hotdogs and talk to thousands of vendors who are doing that and making money. Some of them are doing that and giving half to the church or to the fire department or whatever, making money. I did this. I do this. Here's another question from the I Love Street Food Vending page on Facebook. Troy says, hello to the group. I have a question for y'all. I would like to purchase a new shaved ice trailer early in the spring of 2017. Who is a good quality builder of food trailers? Thanks in advance, Tony. I must say, Tony, I must say, okay, give me just a second. I'm a little biased here, Tony. And I would be remiss if I didn't say, Tony, we make trailers. We make shaved ice trailers. We make any kind of trailer you want. In fact, there's no one on the planet that makes a trailer for less money where you get the most bang for your buck. But let me just tell you, just Google it and go shaved ice trailer. Because really, the trailer has nothing to do with it. It's a shaved ice machine sitting on a counter in a trailer. Different shaved ice machines, and you can pick which shaved ice machine you want and put it on the counter. You don't need like a specifically shaved ice trailer. And I'm not making fun of you. I'm just saying some manufacturers try to fool you and go, oh, well, this is a shaved ice trailer. It's only a shaved ice trailer because you put shaved ice machines in it. Could you go, really, realistically, could you go buy a trailer from a trailer manufacturer, okay, put in a counter, put in what your health department requires, whether that's a ceiling fan or a vent, water supply system, and a shaved ice machine? Well, let me give you a hint. Yes and yes. You can do that yourself. Now, we make that stuff, but you don't have to buy that stuff from me. You can do that yourself. If you're handy, buy it. Buy the trailer. Do it. Save yourself a bunch of freaking money. I'm with you. I want to see you succeed. Buy your next cart for me. You know, when you go, oh, the shaved ice is doing good. I think I'm going to open drop-off catering. Buy that cart from me. I'd rather see you succeed than you buy from me. So, that makes me happy. Okay, I'm looking through my notes. Bear with me. If you are just coming in or came in late, you're not going to want to miss the stuff at the beginning of this. You'll want to go listen to that because we're giving away a cart in less than 60 days, something like that. Well, actually, way less than that. You're going to want to check that out and get signed up. There's nothing to buy. You just sign up. That's it. You text a number. So it's not real, rocket science. Okay. I think, Heather, that I covered everybody's stuff. I do want to tell you that we had, tons of new stuff over at learnhotdogs.com. Heather's been posting up articles. If you miss one of these, you can go back and see it there. Now, obviously you can't win if I'm giving away something on the show, because it's already given away. But, and just a second, we're going to give away this. Booyah. The Steam-O-Matic. Somebody won this last week, and I accidentally ordered two, and I'm going to give away another one here in just a minute. Heather's got to give me a name, because I don't know. You got to be listening live. That's the only way to win. And if there's nobody listening live, then when I do this, I'm doing here in a minute, you see this screen right here, I'm fixing to go through the pros and cons of street food vending. It's like a bonus to this Friday night, live thing on Facebook. So I've got that going, and, I'm going to throw this up real quick. There's that number if you want to stay in touch with us. You want to get updated when we're doing something really cool, really special. Okay? And then I may, here in a minute, show you something real cool that I figured out. I am having so much fun with this new software. And so that's what we're doing. I'm waiting on Heather right now. Okay, I need you to type in hi or something to let me know you're watching right now. Type in hi, type in hello. Type in hot dog, type in food cart, type in something so that I can know you're watching. And Heather's going to take whatever names it is. I don't know how many people are watching. There may be three of you, or there may be 300. I don't know. Any comment you make will let us know that you're here. And then we will pick someone who wins this. Booyah. And you get it sent to you free. It's not like I'm going to go, oh, well, you got to pay for shipping. It's $700. That's a steamer. It steams the, I don't know if you can see this. Look at this right here. It steams the buns and the dogs at the same freaking time. It's just cool to have. I don't know if you have kids or grandkids, but what a cool thing to keep in the kitchen and be able to use. How's the volume, Heather? Can you tell me? I can't tell on my end. I can't tell what's going on, honestly. I'm looking for my stuff. I am losing my mind. Nope. Great volume. All right, we're great volume. And I'm going to be right back. I know that it says it's my picture's going to disappear for just a second. Okay, my picture's going to be disappearing for just a second. Don't worry. I'll be right back. And we'll get going. Okay? I'm going to go right on. I'm going to announce a winner, and then I'm going to go into the pros and cons of the business here in just a second. So give me 2 seconds. If you are watching live, type anything in the comments. We are going to pick a winner from somebody that is watching live. So here in a minute, my camera will be back on, and we're going to pick a winner. So make sure you type in anything you want, a smiley face, say hi, anything in the comments. Are you still with me? Do we have anybody comment? Nobody comment. All right, we'll just move on. I'm gonna turn back on my camera. Takes me a minute to get this stuff done. I don't know why that it works like this, but it does. All right, so here in just a second, we will be we'll be live again on camera. There we are. I don't know if we okay, so here we go. I'm going to run through, because we had the DOS attack, that denial of service attack, last night while we were doing the live webinar. Started out with several hundred people, ended up with about 34 that were able to hear and see me during the live show. It was horrible. And don't know why it did that, but it did. So I am going to run back through what I did last night. And I got several emails from people. I'm moving stuff around, I'm sorry. I got several emails from people asking, would I have an audio version or whatever. We thought that it was going to record it and it would be good. Well, it ended up not being good. So, what we're going to do is the pros and cons of the vending business right now. Let me see. If you'll bear with me just a second, I got to get my notes out. All right, you can see that I have tons of notes. But we're gonna run through this quickly, and so that I don't take up your time. And that I give you as much information so that you can make an informed and educated decision if this business is right for you. If you're already in this business, this probably isn't for you. But if you are on the fence, or thinking or considering or wondering if this could make you money. Listen to this, because I'm going to give you the negatives and then I'm going to give you the positives. Okay? So, Heather, if you want to go, you don't have to be in for this. This may bore you to tears. You've heard it all before. So, I'm going to go through it, and I'm probably not, I have no way of knowing what questions or anything come up, so that won't matter. And I'm going to go ahead and go through these pros and cons, and then anyone can watch it anytime. So here we go. I'm going to move. Let's see here. Bear with me just a second. Let me rearrange my camera. All right, so I am, give me just a second. I'm going to turn back on my camera so you can see everything. And we should be good to go. All right, can you see me? All right, here's the deal. I'm going to say this one more time. We had last night, and I don't know if you watch the news, but if you've watched any news channel, you know that there was a denial of service. It's called a DOS attack on tons of hosting companies who host internet service. Amazon went down. Twitter went down. Instagram went down. Tons of companies went down. They were done. And they came back up. Some of them came back up. Some of them ain't even up yet. So we were trying to do a live broadcast last night for the webinar on pros and cons of street food vending. And it was DOS attacked, not us, but the serving company had a DOS attack. And so it was patchy. Even though they have multiple servers and they kept trying to bounce it, we were getting glitchy information. I talked to the owner today of Expertise TV. He's the actual guru, the owner, and he's the one that wrote the software that runs it. And it was blocked. It was completely blocked. It was, he would switch servers and be on for a few minutes and then back off again. And it, this massive DOS attack. I don't know what we're going to do about this stuff, but somehow there's crazy people that do these DOS attacks and mess us up. If you're wondering, somebody asked what my shirt says. It's Chicks Dig Me. It's Curious George. I know it's corny, but one of my daughters bought it for me. So, anyway, pros and cons of street food vending. Important information, okay? Important information because you don't want to start anything without knowing, doing your homework, doing your due diligence, they call, and finding out, is this something that I'm willing to do? Will I accept the responsibilities, accept the negatives so that I can get these positives? Or do these negatives outweigh these positives? I'm going to give you both. Now, obviously, I'm biased, okay? Hot dogs saved my life. Street food vending is the best thing since sliced bread. It's better than sliced bread ever dreamed to be, and I'd rather pull apart my bread and go and still have street food vending. But it isn't for everybody. So I give the honest truth, cons, pros. Right now, I'm fixing to give you the cons, okay? Because there are cons. There's negatives to this business. There's negatives to any business. And I'm going to give you those. Some of them will be general. And then I'm going to give you the pros. And once you have that information, and you feel free to write these down, okay, or take a snapshot of this video once I get all this listed out for you, And you can go, okay, this will work for me, or this won't work for me. I'm going to get rid of this thingy thing over my head. How's that? All right. So there we are. I have another stupid thing going. Okay. So it's just me and you now, right? And we have the pros and cons. I'm on my porch at night, and I wanted to share this with you. I did this last night, as I just said. So I'm going to grab a couple pieces of, or a couple markers, and go through this with you. So hopefully you can hear me good. Hopefully the volume is good. But let's start with the cons, and I'm going to run through these quickly. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up right here. Post it in the comments. Heather grabs those comments and lets me know, okay? And then I cover it on another live episode. So don't think I ignore your comments. Cons. Here's I'm going to put the cons in red, okay? You're self-employed. Self-employed. And that can be a two-sided coin type deal, but self-employed means self-directed, okay? So you have to have self-direction. No one's going to give you a schedule or threaten you with your loss of a job if you don't show up, because you are your own boss. So it is a con to many people. It's a negative because some people need to be told, be here at 7 a.m. Your lunch is here. We have a potty break here. And they need that. Okay? I'm glad there's people like that because I like to be able to go to the DMV and there be somebody in there. I like to be able to go to McDonald's and there be someone there. Okay, because I don't want to have to go in through the drive-through window and make my own fries and burger. I want to be able to get the burger handed to me through the window. So I don't down anybody's job or position in life at all. I've been at the bottom of the well, you know. But you have to know that's a negative to this business. You have to be able to have self-direction if you're going to be self-employed. You have to be. The next thing that comes with these is you have risk, which is liability. Okay? So, I don't even think I spelled that right. That's the problem with struggling with third grade for 2 years. The risk and liability come with being self-employed. Who's at risk? If you work, I'm going to use McDonald's. I'm going to pick on McDonald's, okay? Not in a bad way, but I'm going to just use them. If you worked at McDonald's, and I have an aunt that works there and has for 20-something years, okay? Right down the street from me, about 4 miles. If you work there and you do something wrong, who gets sued? Does my aunt get sued or does McDonald's get sued? McDonald's. With this being self-employed, you are the owner. You get sued. Now, you may go, oh my gosh, I can't, that's too much risk. Okay, too much risk. Well, no, I've never been sued in the hot dog vending business. I've heard of two vendors ever being sued, and their insurance company took care of it. And in both cases were found to be the fault of the customer. Both cases were children who went up there with their parent and the parent wasn't watching them and they touched something hot, burned their hand. Both cases in 9 years. So is it common for a vendor to be sued? Zip. No. But it's still a risk. It's still a liability. You are liable for your business. If you decide, you know what, I don't care if these hot dogs are 17 years old, and I don't care if they they ain't been refrigerated in 9 years, I'm going to still serve them. You're taking the liability for that. You're taking the risk. So you have to consider that. You have to look at that and go, either you decide, I'm willing to take this, and I'm going to run my business like, you know, I'm going to run a tight ship, or I'm going to willy-nilly it. I'm going to tell you, if you're going to willy-nilly it, you need to go work somewhere else. You don't need to be self-employed. Because this, no matter what you do that's self-employed, you get this with it. You get risk and liability. Okay? Management is the next one. Okay? So I'm going to write that down. Management. Time is money. You've heard it said a blue million times, right? Time and money. Do business owners typically spend more time to make the money? Yes. Statistics show that a self-employed person will spend more time than a employed person to make the same money. Why? Because we're driven. We're driven to be self-employed. We like the idea of freedom. I'm going to get to the pros in a minute, so don't. I'm not bad-mouthing being self-employed. I just want to be honest. I want to give you the facts. But management of your time and money is a trick for a lot of people, okay? This is a trick for a lot of people. A lot of people struggle with managing not only their time, but their money. Money, because they go, oh, I made $600 today. I know I shared this with the vendors at vendorsunited.com. They were talking about this lady. She went out immediately when she made a good weekend, and she went and bought a new car. Okay, she financed a new car and put $4,000 or $5,000 down. I don't remember what it was. And now she ruined her reserve money. Well, would that have happened if she worked at McDonald's? No. It's the management issue. So it's a negative. It's a negative for the fact that if you don't have the self-control, the ability to manage responsibly your money, you could get in trouble quick, okay? Because if you don't have the money to go out and buy your stock because you bought that new schism frozen four-wheel drive with the big mud flaps, you are stuck. You don't want to be there. So these are negatives. And I know some of you, this is preaching to the choir. Some of you, this may be like, well, Ben, this is normal to me, okay? I was checking messages, I'm sorry. So, next thing is a negative to many people is continuing education. You have to constantly stay on your toes and learn new stuff, not be scared of it, not put up roadblocks and walls that prevent you from learning new stuff. So, I'm going to put education. So, you want to get better as you go. You want to get smarter as you go. You want to look at other vendors and go, oh, you're doing this? That's a good idea. And they may inspire you of a new idea. It may be an offspin of their idea. But all that's education. That's good stuff to do. You won't find any real successful business owners who aren't constantly applying information they're learning to their current business model. The ones that go, well, we only accept wooden nickels. That's it. That's the way we've always done it. Well, you know why nobody accepts wooden nickels? Because they've all gone out of business. You have to stay on top of things if you want to be successful. So I'm telling you, even if you go into the medical field, and that's not self-employed, but if you go into the medical field, you would have to continually be educated. Oh, we've come out with new ways to do CPR. CPR, if you don't know, has changed over the years. It used to be five compressions, two breaths. Then it went to five compressions, one breath. Then it went to, I think, 20 compressions, one breath. Well, if you are a nurse, you have to know that stuff. If you are an emergency medical or a first responder or paramedic, you'd have to know that. You can't go, oh, we still do it the old way. You wouldn't get hired because your license wouldn't be renewed because you didn't have that continuing education. Labor. Labor is, I put this down for a reason. Because some people are scared of this. Some people have it in their head that I'm self-employed, which means I don't have to work. Like some magic button happens, and all of a sudden, I'm self-employed, I get a check in the mail each week, everything's good. That's not how that works. So let's go with labor. And in labor, you have to get off the couch. You have to go out and work. Nobody's going to make you, okay? Nobody's going to say, Ben, you need to get out of bed, boy. You got to get out there and make some money. There's stuff to be done, stuff, money to be, you know, you're supposed to be at the Schizofrosm this weekend, and you ain't even prepared for it. Nobody's going to tell me to do that. So I have to do that. So labor, and what if, and a lot of business owners know this, sometimes you're an accountant because you're doing the books, and I do my books on a yellow pad, okay? Then I give it to a bookkeeper who, for $35 a month, converts that over to a QuickBooks thing who gives it to my accountant at the end of the year. It's easy. So I write down my expenses, write down my income, booyah, that's all I do. But it's still something to do. It's a negative. It's something you may not want to do, unless you're an accountant. But you have to do. You have to keep up with this stuff. It's part of the labor. Next day, you may be scrubbing a pan that got burnt by chili, and you're going, I ain't a pan scrubber. Well, you are today, buddy. So, you got to do some of this stuff. Self-reliance. You are relying on yourself and only you. That's it. Okay? You can't blame anybody when you're in this business, when you're in the entrepreneur business. You can't blame anyone. You can't say, well, it's Bob's fault. Bob did it. Bob didn't tell me to be at work today. No, you are Bob. You are your boss. You are your owner. You have to decide. Now, we're going to get into the pros, okay, in a minute. So don't freak out on me and go, oh, my gosh, this is horrible. So you do have that. You also have, and the last thing I'm going to cover, okay, I didn't write down this, but self-reliance. But the last thing is code compliance. I hope you can hear me. I'll repeat it. Code compliance. Code compliance is the worst of it all to me, okay? It's where, and let me explain this quickly, it's where a city or a town or a county says, hey, we don't allow vendors. Or, hey, vendor, we make you move every 15 minutes. Code compliance, okay? Not a big deal if you know what you're doing, okay? Not a big deal. You go, well, Ben, I don't want to, what if I get a good location? I don't want to move every 15 minutes. Well, guess what? You don't have to because federal law protects you from having to do that. And it's only the most ignorant cities in the country that require something stupid like that, who can be held accountable for it and will be if you pursue it. And you go, well, I don't want to have to hire an attorney and don't want to have to blah, blah, blah. You don't. Okay? I have a dear friend, Jason Brown. You can look him up. Love Food Truck Company. Last fall, about this time last year, he wanted to go to a new town in the city. He said, oh, we don't allow vendors. And he went, you can't stop vendors. And they said, oh, yeah, we can. We got a city ordinance that we passed. We voted. And no vendors. Well, Jason already knew this, okay, because he's been with me for a long time. He got the letter from me, sent it to the city mayor, And within hours, literally hours, they said, "Oh, we're sorry. We didn't mean to restrict your rights. Go ahead. Here's your license for $23 or whatever it was." It was over. No city and no city attorney worth his weight and salt is going, once he's aware, okay, most of them just ignorant. It comes down to ignorance. But is going to restrict your rights to vend once they know that the federal courts have already ruled on this. You have in the Bill of Rights in the Constitution, okay, you've heard of your Bill of Rights. The Bill of Rights is your right to work, which means you can operate any enterprise and no city, county, government, state, anything can create a law, code, or ordinance that restricts that right. And if they do, they can be sued. So what we have found is they bend over backwards once they find out that you know your rights. We've never had an issue. Once you tell them, it's over. And I've been doing this 9 years, okay? And I've seen hundreds of these. They all went away instantly. Once you show them, it's over. It's over. They cannot restrict you because there is a federal constitutional law that protects you. And just because this is, I don't want to go into a rant here, but it's crony capitalism. It's basically, I own a big business, I own 17 hotels or 17 restaurants, Pizza Huts, and I'm not going to have no food vendor taking my business. And so because I have power and money, I'm going to go to the city council and vendors. No. Let me tell you what to do. Just go to learnhotdogs.com, okay? And on the side of the page, the right-hand side of the page, is a box that says search. Type in that box, justice. Justice. And you will get the information you need, all of it, to counter any stupid city or county who thinks they're going to restrict your federal rights. That's it on the negatives. We're done with the negatives. So let's switch color pens. Okay, let's switch color pens. Let's go with, I say we go with green, color of money. Okay, and let's do the pros real quick, and I'm going to get you done and out of here. All right, here's the pros. And it's kind of going to sound similar to the cons. You ready? Pros. We already have our cons. Our pros: own boss. Be own boss. Okay? Now, you're your own boss. So, even though it was a negative over here, what are the positives of being your own boss? Well, it means when the granddaughter has a soccer game, you get to go. You don't have to call in sick and play like, "Sorry, John, I can't come in, I'm real sick," and then go down to your granddaughter's soccer game. When your son has a sporting event, you can go. When you need to spend time with your family and have something you need to do, like an emergency fishing trip, you just go. That's the benefit of being your own boss. Freaking love it. Time with family and freedom. Time with family. I want to put this. This is part of this. Time with family equals freedom. That is success to me. That is quintessentially the epitome of success. Freedom. Freedom. I don't care. To you, you may need $300,000 a year to be successful, to call yourself successful. I may need $100,000 a year. John may need $50,000 a year. Is there anything wrong with either one of our answers? Nope. If we have freedom, with that money, then we have success. That's it. That's it. Period. So, freedom is success. Freedom is success. And how do you get that? Being your own boss. Right here. Be your own boss. I'm my own boss. Tomorrow, If I don't want to answer one stinking phone call, I don't have to. Nobody's going to be mad at me. Nobody's going to... Now, I may have some people that called that pissed off, but nobody's going to fire me, right? Now, I may be deluged Sunday trying to catch up on all the voicemails on this, but the bottom line is I don't have to work tomorrow. If somebody in my family needs me tomorrow, I can go. Doesn't matter what I had scheduled. I can go and help my family or help my friend. If Corey Lawrence or Jason or John or Lily or Tammy or one of those called me and said, Ben, I really need you tomorrow, I'm going to be there. I'm going to be there. Well, I have stuff to do. I don't have to call in sick. I don't have to tell nobody. I just go do it. There's a pro, okay? Self-reliance. Self-reliance. Do you remember self-reliance? Right here. Self-reliance. Well, it's also here, okay? You are self-reliant. Remember I told you it's a pro and a con? Because with it comes responsibility, but also comes freedom. So self-reliance is a plus to me. I'm reliant on me. I don't have to worry about 16 other people. I got to worry about me. If I go out, I make money. If I don't go out, I don't make money. Who do I rely on? Me. Me. That's it. Uncapped income. Go get a job anywhere, anywhere on the planet, and ask them if the income is capped, which means it has a ceiling. Well, of course it does. Go to McDonald's. How many people at McDonald's working at McDonald's have an uncapped income? How many people working at the electric company have an uncapped income? Altogether total, add them all up. It's none. None. You know why? Because they're not self-employed. Self-employed people have an uncapped income. And I don't know if I spelled that right, but uncapped income, I think it has two P's. Uncapped income means you get to make whatever you want to make. Now, I will tell you, you can get gung-ho. I went gung-ho with this and got 22 carts my first year, and, oh, I was making good money, but good God almighty, it was ridiculous. I didn't have any time to do nothing else. I was running around like a crazy squirrel, right, who'd been nicked in the head by a Ford pickup truck. It just didn't make good sense. To me, uncapped income is working smarter, working less hours for more money, figuring out which times to work produce the most income, and then work those hours and work those days or those weeks. Like, I figured out that at the end of the month and the beginning of the month were the best times to work. The middle of the month, not so much. So guess what Ben did in the middle of the month? He fished. Still do. You figure this stuff out. I kept records. I just kept yellow pad notes. And I went, okay, I did this today. It was rainy. And then just a month or two of that, I went, oh, I need to be at the Dollar General on Tuesdays, but only on the second Tuesday of the month, because that's the best day. And slowly I figured out what days to work and where to work and when to work and how long to work. Vendors don't work 10-hour days. We don't. We work 4 to 5 hours a day. So there's that for you. Now, if you do go into restaurant business and stuff, you will work more, guaranteed. Okay. Catering and events, huge income. So that's another benefit to me. You have catering. You have, and I didn't tell you about this, drop-off catering. Wait till you hear. We have vendors doing nothing but drop-off catering. Let me tell you real quick. I'm going to spend 10 seconds. It's where somebody calls you up and goes, hey, Ben, we have a family reunion. We would like spaghetti. And can you bring a cart and enough spaghetti for 83 people? And they go, how much is it? And I go, well, about $9 a plate. I'll bring all the drinks, coolers, everything. I'll drop it off. I'll show you how to use the cart, and then I'll leave, and then you tell me when to pick it up, or I'll pick it up the next day. Done. I did not serve anything. I did not do anything, and I made $1,800. We have vendors doing that full-time now. Full-time. Just drop-off catering. So I'm going to put that here, too. Drop-off catering. And then regular catering, where you actually go to somewhere. You know, Jason just did a catering gig day before yesterday. I think he said 200-something covers at $9 a piece in about 2 hours. So do the math on that. It's about $900 an hour. Not bad money. Now, the other thing, bad economy or a good economy is good for us. Doesn't matter. Bad economy or good, we make more money. Bad economy, people look for value. Good economy, people go, oh, I'm going to try this. Instead of going to McDonald's every dang day, I'm going to try this. So either way we win. I did a video called A Bad Economy is Good for Me back when I was vending almost, I was still vending 2-3 days a week. Because bad economies, I made more money. Part-time or full-time, I'm hurrying. Part-time or full-time, you can work part-time or full-time, you decide. We have vendors. Okay, I'll give you one right now. You can look it up, call him. Michael Wood, Doug's Dogs in Georgia, Podunkville, Little Town, 6 days a month. Used to work 3 days a month. Now he works, he's doubled his work 6 days a month. That's what he works, full-time income. There's other vendors doing it. There's other vendors doing it. We have a vendor that we had on the show that works, they work 3 or 4 months a year, and they make enough money in those 4 months, to take the rest of the year off. They work on a pontoon boat with a big dog cart. Now they have 2 big dog carts on the same pontoon boat in a lake through the summer months. I forgot where I was now, but so part-time or full-time. So you get part-time, part or full-time, you decide. What your income needs are, okay? What you need, and that determines how much you work. You can expand. You can expand like Corey did, like so many did, okay? You can go from a cart. Corey started with a build-a-cart. He built a cart, okay? We teach that at buildacart.com, buildacart.com. Build a cart for less than $900. Move on up to a food trailer. I'm getting eat up by mosquitoes. I'm outside. Then went to a restaurant. And now he's got a restaurant plus one of my Cater Pro carts. And he's working constantly. So you can, it's expandable. It's whatever you want it to be. We have vendors with, I've got a vendor here in East Tennessee. Well, he's in Middle Tennessee. He's not far from me. But he's still, you know, Middle Tennessee. I'm East Tennessee. And he's doing, I think he's got 9 of my carts now. And he's running them all with employees. And then we've got a vendor in Louisiana with 70-something carts. There's a vendor in California with over 100 carts. So can you expand it to whatever you want? Yes. Depends on how, you know, crazy you are and how much you want to, headaches you want. I know that sounds negative, but I couldn't stand it. I don't want to ever have that many employees again. I don't want to deal with that many carts again. I'm not trying to talk you out of it, and I'll give you tips on how to do that the right way. I screwed up because I was new, and so I made lots of mistakes. I love you. I'm glad you watched this. I hope that it helps. I hope that you, it helps you. I hope that you get better at what you're doing. And that you can, that it changes your life. But at the very least, you got enough information to make an educated and informed decision whether, hey, this isn't for me. I don't like all these cons, Ben. I'm going to go to McDonald's or whatever. Okay? doesn't mean McDonald's. You could go into another type of self-employment, but most of these apply to any self-employment job. These are where it changes, because most self-employed jobs, you don't get all of these benefits. Street food vending, hot dog vending, catering, drop-off catering, event catering, event work, all that stuff. It gives such a variety, such a avenue for everybody that, to me, it's the world's perfect business. To me, it changed everything. And it made it all worthwhile. I made $86,000 last year just doing drop-off catering because I wanted to buy a piece of land. And so I did that on the side. Drop-off catering. That way I didn't have to work much. $86,000. And you go, well, you've been doing it a while. Nope. I can tell you this. You follow just my steps, you can do this. There's no magic to this. There's no, oh, you got lucky. No. Everybody that does these steps wins. It's an ABC thing. It's a paint a wall. If I take paint out and I go, hey, John or Jill or whatever your name is, and I go, let's paint that wall yellow, and you go, well, it takes a lot of luck to paint a wall yellow. Got to have a lot of luck. Nope. Yellow paint, paintbrush, we got a yellow wall, right? That's how this is. Is it still work? Yes. Is it still a job? Is there still some stresses? Is there still some obstacles that you may come across? Yes. But we've all been through them. Not all of them by one person, but all of us have encountered different things. And we share that information at learnhotdogs.com, where you can get all the information you want and become as good as you want to be, make the money that you want to make your first month. I made $8,000, a little over $8,000 my first month vending, and I knew nothing. I didn't have a bin. I didn't have anybody telling me what to do and how to do it. I was winging it. That's called luck. I've learned a lot since then, but I managed to make over $127,000 my first year. You can too. Period. No luck. No chance. Everybody that does this gets this. You add 2 plus 2, you get 4. Doesn't matter how many people do it or who does it. They all get 4. If they don't get 4, they were just wrong. They don't know how to add. This is that way. And I wish you well. I wish you the most success. If I can help you at all, enter comments below, and I'll try to get to them on the next live episode. If you miss any episode and you're going, oh my gosh, this, you know, learnhotdogs.com, I keep everything there, plus on YouTube. Not the podcast, but everything else is on YouTube. And let me know if I can help you. I love you. I wish you well. Thanks.